Hello students, welcome to my mess class once again. So in the last class, I have done up to exercise 11F, up to question number 2 of chapter number 11. Now I shall start from question number 3 of exercise 11F. So exercise 11F, okay? Chapter number 11, okay? Chapter number 11. So see the questions. So from question number 3 we shall start. For each polygon, write down the number of sides, names, name the polygon. The first shape has 3 sides. It is a triangle. Okay. So what? You have to name the what? Triangle. You have to name the polygons. So how to name the polygons? Yes. Come to page number 215. So come to page number what? 215 and see types of polygon. So what? According to their sides, their special name has been given. So what? If a polygon has 3 sides, then it is what? Triangle. If a polygon has 4 sides, then quadrilateral. 5 sides, then pentagon. P-E-N-T-A-G-O-N, pentagon. Then what? 6 sides, hexagon. 7 sides, heptagon. 8 sides, octagon. 9 sides, nonagon. And 10 sides, what? Decagon. So you can learn this one from what? Page number 215, it is there in the first portion. Page number 215, it is given in the what? First portion. Triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, heptagon, octagon, nonagon, decagon. Okay? So you can learn from there. Now, just to count the sides and write their names. So here, 1, 2, 3 sides. So it is triangle. And it is given in the book. This one you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 sides. So 8 sides, it is what? Octagon. Octagon. This one you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 sides. So it is what? Hexagon. Hexagon. This one you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sides. So 7 sides, it is what? Heptagon. Heptagon, okay? So it is what? Heptagon, okay? Now come to question number E. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 sides, it is what? Quadrilateral, as you have learned earlier. Quadrilateral. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means what? It is what? Pentagon. 5 sides means what? Pentagon. Pentagon. This one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. It is what? 5. It is what? Again pentagon. Pentagon. Now come to this one, H. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. H, it is what? 7. So 7 means what? Heptagon. Heptagon. Okay. Now come to this one, I. So what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is what? Again what? Hexagon. Hexagon. Now come to this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7, that is what? It is heptagon. It is what? It is heptagon. Okay. Now come to K. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So how many? So what? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This one. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, one side I think extra. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one 6. Okay. 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now you see there are what? 8. So it is what? Octagon. It is what? Octagon. It is what? Octagon. Okay. Now come to L. Okay. So, first side I am roughing. What to say? Erasing. L, M. So, in L what is there? L it is like this. The shape is like this. So let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One side more, I think. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this side 10. So what? It is decagon. 10 sides, that is what? Decagon. Okay. Now what? Now come to M. In M, what is there? So see how many side, let us count. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it is what? Nonagon. It is what? Nonagon. So now question number 3 finished. Now come to question number 7, that is high order thinking skill. So for question number 7, the figure I have drawn this one, okay? So, earlier I have drawn the figure. See, from this figure, we need to find what? How many pentagons are there? How many hexagons are there? How many heptagons are there? And how many octagons are there? How many octagons are there? Okay? So, this one, you write answer here. So this one high order thinking skill, okay? Question number 7, Roman 1. So Roman 1, you will count later, okay? Come to Roman 2, how many hexagons are there? Yes, how many? So what? How many hexagon are there, we need to find that one. Okay, so what you see in this side, there are what, two heptagon. How you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So there are what, two heptagons. One is this one and another is what, this one. So if this is heptagon, so this will be heptagon. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 7. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what? C also keep, whatever you are getting, let us see. So see what, how many heptagons are there? Two heptagons we have found. Now how many octagons are there? Yes, let us check this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this one, 1 octagon. So this one, 7 sides. So these are what, heptagon. Okay, this one, 8 sides. Okay, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 sides. So 2 octagons are there. Two heptagon. Okay, so what, now what, now question number B, how many hexagons are there? Hexagon, that is what, 3 side. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So only one hexagon. Okay, only one hexagon, number D, number, sorry, A, B, A, here B, we have only one hexagon. Okay, now how many pentagons are there? Yes, there are what, 10 pentagons. If you count, then find there are 10 pentagons. Okay, like this, if you count, then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, like this, if you count, okay, then you will find what, 10, what, 10 pentagons are there. Okay, you go on counting, will find what, 10 pentagons. 10 pentagons. Okay, 10 pentagons. Okay, so this is the end of this chapter number 11. Now let's move to chapter number 12. The name of the chapter is what? Three dimensional shapes. So what is three dimensional shapes? What we call the, what is known to us, that is what, 3D. Okay, so what, three dimensional shapes, that means what, which we cannot draw in a what, in a plane. Okay, that is what, this rectangle, if I draw a rectangle, okay, so rectangle I can draw in this board because it is a plane, board is a plane. So in a plane surface I can what, draw it, this rectangle. But if I want to draw a keyboard, okay, or a box, okay, or a box, okay, or a box, then what, okay, then you see this side, okay, so the last part, whatever there, the last part we cannot what, see this one, what, I cannot draw exactly, what, I cannot show this one, this portion, what, I cannot show, because it is a what, 3D shape. That means what, a shape which has length, breadth and height, length, breadth and what, height, and that can be represented, if you go for the higher classes, then you find that what? 3D shapes can be represented, in what? Three coordinates, x, y, z coordinate, and plane, and what? And the plane figure can be represented in what? Two coordinates, that is x, y coordinate. Okay, and this thing's what? In three coordinates. We need what? A three coordinate, like this. A three coordinate. Okay, so simply you understand for this class, simply you understand a shape which has what? Length, breadth, and height. Three things are there. That is what? A solid shape or a 3D shape. Okay, now let's draw some figures. Okay, and in this three dimensional shapes, we will be learning about the shapes, 3D shapes, and we shall learn how many faces they have, how many edges they have, how many what corners they have. Corners is what? Vertex also you can say. So let's first start with the what? Cuboid. So what? Now let's start with what? Cuboid. So here you see. So if I say about the cuboid, then what? This is a cuboid. A cuboid has what? How many faces? Six faces. Yes. How? In sides, in four sides, there are what? Four faces. Okay. Here from there one, then from there two, then from there three, then from there four. Okay, four faces and one top and one bottom. That is what? In total how many faces? Six faces. So what? A cuboid has what? Six faces. Okay, and what? And how many edges? So what do you mean by edges? Okay, so what? An edge is a line segment that is the intersection of two faces. Then what? An edge is an what? Line segment. It is an intersection of two faces. Suppose this is one face. Okay, actually this portion, this line segment is called what? Edges. This portion is called what? Edges. And these things are called what? Face. Okay, face, this one edges. And corners, that means what? Vertex, square. Two vertex meet, that is what? Where two edges meet, that is called what? Corners or vertex, we can say. So how many corners are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many corners? 8 corners. How many corners are there? Yes, there are what? 8 corners. So faces 6. So edges, how many edges are there? Let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So how many? Yes, 12 edges are there. So how many edges? 12 edges. How many? 12 edges. Okay, and how many corners? 8 corners. 8 corners. What? 8 corners. How many corners? 8 corners. Okay. Now, if you come for cube, then what? In cube also what? Same faces, but in cube, the difference is that in cube all the faces are same. All the faces are what? Same. That is what they have. The measure of all the faces are same. So if I draw this one, and it will become a what? Cube. So what? This is a what? Cube. So this one also have what? Same thing. What? How many faces? 6 faces, 12 edges, and 8 corners. So these have what? Both are same. Same. Okay. but the difference is that what in cubit length, breadth, height are different. Okay, but in cube length, breadth, height all are same. Okay, now come towards cylinder. So cylinder, you have seen cylinder. So this one I can say that what it is a cylinder. So in cylinder there are two flat or plane. Okay, two flat or plane. Okay, plane faces. Okay, how many? Yes, this one one face and this one another face. Okay, this one one face and this one what, this one and this one another face. And what, and which are circular regions and one curved surface. One curved is what? So if I make it circle, okay, suppose this is a cylinder. So I can say that what, this is a cylinder. Okay, two faces are there. Okay, two faces are there and this one curved. Okay, curved. So what, one curved faces is there. Okay, and it is what, two edges. It is what, two edges. Okay, this one one edge, this one one edge. Okay, and this one another edge. Okay, this one what, two edges. And what, no corners. And what, no corners. There is no corners because what, this one is circular shape. Okay, that means what, there is what, no corners. Okay, now come to cone. So cone, we have seen. So this one is a what, this one is a cone. So what, in cone, a cone looks like a what, spinning top or the cap of circus. Okay, in circus we used to see some cap just to put. So it is shaped like this. Okay, so it has what, one flat face. Yes, that is what, this face. Okay, one flat face. So if I say this one, and if this one is cut, okay, then it will become like this. So I can say that what, this one was, this one has what, one curved surface. This is what, this one circular, one curved surface. Okay, curved. Cone is what, one curved surface, and it has what, one edge and one corner. One edge and what, one corner. Yes, one corner I can say, because these two line segments meet here. Okay, where two line segment what, where the edges meet. Okay, this is what, corners, or you can say vertex. So this is what, one corner, one corner. Okay, so this one what, one curved face. And what, one curved face. And what, and one edges, as like earlier, this one one edges. Okay, one edges. Okay, now let us move to sphere. So sphere, you have seen, if we say, take an example of football. Okay, so it is our sphere. Or in the school, what we say, global is there, na? Okay, so this is one sphere. So what, in sphere what, no edges, no edges. Okay, no corners, no edges, no corners. And it has what, only one face. If you see everywhere, you see what, same. So what, only one faces. And the face is what, and the face is of what, curved face. Only one curved face. This is what, sphere. Sphere. This one is what, cone. Okay, this one cylinder. Cylinder, cone, sphere. This one what, cube. Cube. This one what, cuboid. This one what, cuboid. This one what, sphere. So it is what, one curved surface or face, you can say. So have you
So have you understood?
Curved means what? Circular face, okay? Now come to what? Triangular prism. So these things will get, I think you go to Google and what search what that prism, then you understand what is prism. If you go, a prism is a what? A thing what? Which we used to do what practical, the help of this prism we used to do practical in the higher classes, that what it diverts the rays. If you keep one rays and if you if you what try to pass one ray and if you keep one what prism there, then what it diverts, okay, diverts or converts, anything, the work of this prism is to what diverge and convert like this. So see in the Google, okay, you just type what prism, okay, triangular prism, then we'll find, and we'll find also the working of this, the functions of this. So it is shaped like this triangular prism. That means what? The faces will be what? In triangular shape. Okay. So let me show. It is like this. Triangular prism, if I draw, then what? Then it is like this. Okay. This looks like this. Okay, triangular prism. A triangular prism has five faces. How? This one face, this one face, two, then three, then from this side another four, and the bottom one. It is what? Five faces. Okay? And what? Six corners. That is what? Vertex. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is what? Triangular prism. Triangular prism. Triangular prism. So now let us come to what? Square prism. So it is same, okay? Square prism, that means earlier it was triangular prism. The face was like triangular shape. Now it is what? Square prism, that means what? The bottom is a square. It is in the shape of a square. Okay? So what? This is what? So this is a what? Triangular prism. That is what? This is the what? Bottom part. Okay? This is the bottom part and there are four faces, four triangular faces. Okay? Sorry, five faces. Okay. That is what? 1, 2, then 3, then 4, then the bottom one, 5 faces. Okay? So what, they have what? Five faces and what? Five corners. Five corners. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five corners. So that is what? Square prism. This is what? This is what? Square prism. Okay? Now come to what? Triangular pyramid. So pyramid, you know about the pyramid, okay? So triangular pyramid, how it is? You see. So if I draw here triangular pyramid, then you can understand. Triangular pyramid, it is of like this. Earlier it was a square pyramid, that's mean square pyramid, sorry, this one square pyramid. Square pyramid, that means what? It is a height, okay? It is a what? Slant height, okay? Square pyramid, now what? Triangular pyramid. That means what? The bottom face is what? Like a triangle. The bottom face is what? Like a triangle. The bottom face is what? Like a triangle. So this is a what? This is a triangular prism. That means what you see? The bottom part is what? Like a triangle. So this is what? Triangular. Triangular pyramid. This is what? Triangular pyramid. Okay. Now how many faces this have? Yes, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Then what? 4. So 1, 2, then another one, 3. Then this bottom face. Okay. 4 faces. Okay. Then what? Then how many edges? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 6 edges. Now come to corners. How many corners? 1 corner, 2 corner, 3 corner, 4 corner. Okay. There are what? 4 corners. So this is what? Triangular prism. Okay. Now let's move with the what? Exercise. So in exercise 12A, how many edges does the figure have? How many edges does the figure have? I need to draw that. How many edges does the figure have? So see how to draw this. How many edges does the figure have? You need to write their names. So chapter 12, three-dimensional shapes. Three-dimensional shapes. 12A. Okay, so let me draw the figure. So what? So this is a what? Cuboid. And the name is what given? A B D. This one C. This one F. This one H. This one G. This one what? G. Now the question is that What is the shape? What is the shape? The question is that what? How many edges does the figure have? So we know what? In a what? In a cubit there are what? How many faces? In a cubit there are 12 faces. So you can write directly number 1. 12 faces. In a what? In a triangle there are what? In a cubit there are what? How many faces? 12 faces. If you count this one, they will find what? 12 faces are there. Okay? Now what? Okay, so see this figure. Okay, so which edges have the same length? So you need to see what? Which edges have the same length? So what? This AB, this line is parallel to what? This line and this line are same. AB and this one what? One name even yes, E. So AB and EF will be same. Okay, AB and EF will be same. Then what? CD. CD and GH will be same. CD and GH will be same. So write which faces are, which edges have the same length, which edges have the same length. So AB and this one, these two are same. So write what? First you write what? Number B. Which one same? AB. Okay, so first you write AB. And which one? This is the symbol of line segment. AB matching with what? Okay, AB matching with what? EF. EF. Then CD. CD matching with what? GH. CD matching with what? CD matching with what? GH. CD or DC? CD matching with what? GH. Okay. CD matching with what? GH. Now what? Now AD matching with GF. So right. AD matching with this one is matching with GH. So AD matching with what? GH. Okay. AD matching with what? AD matching with what? GH. Okay. So these all are what? These all are line segment. So AD matching with. So what? AD matching with what? AD matching with what? AD matching with what? GF. GF, then again what? AD, AD matching with what? BC, AD matching with what? AD matching with BC. So first you write AD matching with what? BC. Then what? Then AD matching with what? This one matching with this one, EH. EH, okay? Then what? If EH matching, then this one matching GH.
GH also what? Matching. Okay. Now what? Now let us come to. Now anyone more? AE. AE matches with BF. AE matches with BF. Okay. AE matches with what? BF. Okay. Then what? BF. Then DH. DH matches with what? CG. DH. AE matches with what? DH. AE matches with what? AE matches with DH also. Okay? DH. Okay? So if you actually this is a 3D shape, so I cannot say this is one corner and this is one what? This is one edges and this is one edges. So actually these are same. Okay? Now what? And what? And DH. DH. And DH matches with what? CG. CG. So what? These are the edges with which they matches. Okay. So this is one pair. They are same. This is one pair. They are same. And this is another group. They are same. This is one group. They are same. This is one group. They are same. And this is another group. They are same. Okay. Now question number C. What is there? Name all the edges in the drawing at the right angles. Sorry, name all the edges in the drawing at the right and the faces which intersect to form these edges. That means what? You have to write like this, that this is what? AB. This is a edge what? AB. Okay. Okay. So with this AB, how many extra edges were made? Yes, with this AB, these faces have been made. That means what? With the what? With the edges, with the help of AB edges, how many faces are made? So I can say that with the help of AB edges, this face has been made. So I can write with the help of AB edges, ABCD face has been made. ABCD, this face, because these edges what? Touch with this face. Okay. Now another face also I can say, this AB what? This AB is used to draw this one also. So I can write AB used to draw ABFE also. AB, AB, CD, then what? AB, then what? ABFE also. Then what? ABFE also. ABFE. ABFE also. So I can write this one what? ABFE also. Okay? ABFE. Finished. Now come to what? With this AB, it is finished. Okay? Okay, now come to BC. With BC, how many are made? With BC, how many? BCGH or BCGH, right? B, C, G, H, one face. And is there any more face? Yes, this one. A, B, C, D. With this face is connected. I can write what? A, B, C, D. This face. A, B, C, D. Now is there any more? No. This B, C is connected with this face and this face. Okay, now come to what? Now come to EF. Okay, now this face EF. AB finished, BC finished, now EF. Okay, so let me write here. Okay, so EF. EF matches with how much? EF, 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 EF matches with EFGH. You can write what? EFGH. Now, is there any more with EF? With EF? Yes. With EF also? With EF, ABCD also meet. With EF what? ABFE. 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 You see, with EF, AB, this one is there. So I can write ABFE. This phase has been what? Made. Okay. And another one, EFGH. Okay. Now let us come to what? FG. Now let us come to what? FG. FG. With FG, you see FG. With FG, this phase. With FG, this phase has been made. So if I write this phase, then what I can say? EF, what? FG. FGCB. FGCB. Okay. So I can write what? Or E with FG. With FG, first this one made. EFGH. So with FG, this one also what? This one also connected. So this one also connected. So what? With FG, first will write what? With FG, I can write FGCB. FGCB. This one. We can write like this anyway. CGFB or BFGC. In any way, you can write, no problem. This may vary, okay? Now this one. EFGH also. With this edges, this one and this face linkage. That is the top bottom is what? Linked with GF or FG. So I can write this one EFGH. EF. EFGH. EF. EFGH. So EFGH. Okay. Now FG finished. Okay. Now come to DC. Now come to what? DC. Now come to what? Now come to DC. So in DC, ABCD. So in DC, what? ABCD. ABCD. Okay. In DC, what? ABCD. And another one with DC, I can take this one. Okay. That is CD. 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 HG. So I can write what? CDHG. Okay. CDHG. 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 Okay. Now come to AE. Now come to what? AE. In AE, how many matching? In AE. AE, CAE, what? AE. Yes, with AE, AEFB is made. AEFB. So write AEFB. With AE, AEFB, this one made. And with AE, this phase also made. So I can write what? AEHD. Okay? AEHD also I can write. Okay, with AE, this one, this phase also has made. So I can write what? DA, DA, DAEH, EH. Okay, now what? Now come to then HG. With HG, what? With HG, how many made? What? With HG. So if I take then with HG, 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 then this portion. So I can write this one, that EFGH, you can write EFGH, this face with HG, EFGH, then this one DCGH with what HG? DCGH, DC
DC or DH, CG, DH, DH, GC. So write DH, GC. Okay. Now HG finished. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need to write 12. Okay, 12 faces are there for that reason. Okay. 7 details. Now come to what? DH. DH. So what? In case of what? DH. Okay. DH. So DH would DH. This face has been made. DH. So I can write DH GC. So DH GC. Okay. One made. Now what? DH GC. Now with DH. DH what? This one what? DH GC. So what? DH, DH, GC. So this one also made with this face. D, DH, this one. Okay. So I can write what? DAEH, DAEH, DAEH also. Okay. DAEH. Okay. Now come to what? Then come to AD. With AD. So here no space. Okay. So I am writing here. This one what? This one C. Okay. So if you write like this, then in AD you will find. So okay, you count like this. In AD. In AD you will find what? In AD you will find ABCD. Again, ABCD. A, B, C, D. Then what? D, A, E, H. In AD, D, A, E, H. So D, A, D, A, E, H. This one will find. Okay. Okay. Now what? Now in case of what? Now in case of what? B, F. In case of what? B, F. So what? B, F. B, B, F. So in case of B, F, I can take what? This one. Okay. So in case of what? BF, I can write what? ABFE. AB, ABFE. Okay. ABFE. Okay. ABFE. Now what? So in case of what? And what? CBFG. And what? CBFG. CB, CBFG. So this face with what? BF. So CBFG, okay, CBFG, and no more. Now come to the edges. What? EH, EH, okay. Earlier you have done what? EF. Now what? EH. So in EH, so in EH it is what? EFGH, EH, EH. With EH, EFGH. E F G H, okay. E F G H, and what? And what? D with E H, E H. So I can write D A E H, D A E H also, D A E H also. I can write. Now come to C G. In C G, in C G, C G. That is what? This one C G. So in CG I can write this one BFCG. I can write BFCG. Okay. CG. Okay. And with this CG what? Again this one made. So I can write what? D, DCGH. Okay. DCGH. So another one I am writing here. DCGH. Okay. And this one BFCG. Okay. So these are the answers. Okay, this one. Okay, so these are the answers. Now come to question number 2. So in question number 2, what is given? This drawing shows a cube. What is the shape of each face? Yes, since this is a what? Cube. So in a cube, all the faces are equal. Okay, all the faces and all the sides are equal. That is what? It is a what? Square. Because what? To make a cube, what? We need a what? We need a what? Square. We need a what? Square portion of sheet or anything, okay? Square portion of anything. So it is what? So what is the shape of each face? The shape of each face will be what? Square. Because if I draw a what? If I draw a cube, then the shape is like this. Okay? So see, all the faces are same. So if I see, then this face, this face, this face, this face, this face, all are what? Same. All are what? Square shape. So this is what? So that one I can say that what? This is a what? Square. Okay? So this one is a what? Square. So I can say that what? So I can say that what? 12. Sorry. Question number 2. Number A. What? Number A it will be what? Number A it will be what? Square. Number A it will be what? Square. Number 2. Is each edge in this figure of the same length in each edge? In each edge in this figure of the same length? Yes, because what? All the edges will be same, because since the faces are square, that means what? In a square the sides are same, so the edges will be what? Same. So what? Number B. Yes, what? The figure in each edge is this figure of the same length. Yes, yes, the edges, just to write yes. Okay, in each edge is this figure of the same length. In each edge in this figure is of the same length. Yes, each edge in this figure of the same length. Same length. Right, because the faces of a cube are shaped like a square. And in square, all the sides are same. All the sides are same. Therefore, the edges of this figure are same. Okay, you write like this details. Now come to question number 3. Is your mess book shaped like cube? Why? What do you think of an alphabet block? Yes, if I take this mess book, then is this look like square? No, it is a cuboidal shape. It is in what? Cuboidal shape. Okay, this is height, this is breadth, and this is what? Length. So it is not a what? So it is not a what? Cube. It is a what? A cuboid. It is in what? Cuboid shape. So no. So we like to write what? No. Is your mess book shaped like a cube? No. So write no. My mess book is not shaped like a cube. So write. Right. No. No, my maths book is, no, my maths book is not shaped like a cube. Full stop. It is
in cuboid. It is in what? It is in cuboid shape. It is in cuboid shape. It is in what? It is in cuboid shape. So one thing, no, my mess book is not shaped like a cube, because the one thing right, because the length, breadth and height are not same. Because the length, breadth and height are not same. It is shaped. It is shaped like a cuboid. That is the answer. Okay, it is shaped like cuboid. Okay. Now come to question number. Now, can you name what to say? What do you think of an alphabet block? Yes, it is a cube. So write. This is next part. So you write. Yes, alphabet. Yes, alphabet block is in cube shape. Okay, yes, we know, we have seen the alphabet block that you have to measure like this, what we used to play. So it is what you see, this one, if you see that, then this is in cube shape. Okay, now can you name three other objects that are shaped like a cube? So can you name what three other objects that are shaped like a cube? So one I am saying, that is what, very easy, ludo dice. Okay, ludo dice, have you seen? This is what, 1 2 3, in 6 faces, 1 2 3 4 5 6 written, okay. So what, that, so that is what shaped like a what, cube shape. So one example I am giving, what example of, example of cube shape object. Number one, I can write what? Ludo. Two, you write from your own. Okay, I am writing one. Ludo dice. Okay, Ludo dice. Then another also you can write what? That what? Ice cube sugar. This is also shape same like. Another one, sugar cubes. Have you seen sugar cubes like this? So these are also shaped like what? Cube. So this is the answer. So one I am written, these two, whatever I said by mouth, this one also you can write, or other also you can write, no problem. So this is up to you, you write any. Okay. Now come to question number 4. Match the following. One curved surface, one plane surface. One curved surface, okay, circular, and one plane surface. So which one match? It is match with what? It is match with E cone. Yes, it is match with what? E cone. So we know about cone. Okay, so come to question number 4. So question number 4, what? Cone. 4A, it will be what? Cone. 4A will match with what? Roman 1, 4 Roman 1 will match with what? E. It is cone. It is like this. Okay. So what? It is what? One curved surface and one plane. So one curved surface. Okay. And what? One plane. This is what? Plane face. So what? One plane surface. So this is one plane surface. So it is what? Cone. Okay. Now number 2. What is there? One unbroken curved surface. One unbroken curved surface. What? There is what? No, that will be what? Sphere. So what? That match with what? One unbroken curved surface. That is what? This curved surface. What? Break here. Okay. But this is what? An unbroken curved surface. So it is, I can say that what is a sphere. So this is what E cone I can write. Okay. Then number two, what it is D. It will be sphere. Now number three. So in number three, what is there? One curved surface, two plane faces of equal size. Yes, one curved size surface and two what? Two plane surface of equal size. So this one will be cylinder. This one will be what? Cylinder. One curved surface. So this is the what? Curved surface and two plane surface. Okay. So I can write what? This is cylinder. So this one I can write what? Cylinder. Number four. So number four, what is there? Number four, six square faces. So six square faces, that is what? It is what? Cube. Six square faces, it will be what? Cube, as I said earlier. Okay, it will be what? Cube. So what? That will be what? Cube. So cube is in question A. So it is what? Cube. So like this, number five, one square base, four triangular faces. One square face, four triangular faces. So it will be what? Pyramid. So as I said earlier, okay, one square base and four what? And four triangular faces. So it is what? Pyramid. Now what? Number six, three rectangular faces. Yes, three rectangular faces and what? Two triangular base of equal size. So it is what? Triangular prism. So it is what? Triangular what? Prism. So write what? It is what? Triangular prism. So it is what? Triangular prism. Okay. Now come to question number five. So in question number five, what is given? That tell whether each of the following figure is a plane figure or a solid figure. That means what? Plane figure, that means what? Which I can what? Which I can draw and show in what? In this whiteboard. And cube, this one I cannot show because land by the height. That means what? The 3D shapes that I cannot show, that are what? Solid figure. Okay. So what? Cube. Cube is a solid figure. Okay. Cone also is a solid figure. So this one you write here. So just I am writing answer. Okay. So write number one, A5A. Q will be what? Solid. Okay. Then what? B will be again what? Solid. Cone. Okay. C will be quadrilateral. Quadrilateral will be plane. Because what? This quadrilateral I can show here. So this is a quadrilateral. But to show a what? Cubed, I cannot show. Because what? This one what? This or this side what? I cannot what? Draw. The dot portion what? We need to draw here. This is what? This is in the back side. Okay. That what? That you cannot draw in the what? Plane. So that is what? It is 3D. So what? C quadrilateral, so I can draw. It is what? Plane. It is what? Plane figure. So solid figure you write. Okay. I mean figure. Okay. Plane figure. Number D. So number D what? Number D circle. So circle also plane. I can draw circle in board. Number E cylinder. It is also what? Cylinder. It is also solid. Okay. Now F, what is there? Triangle I can show in board. Okay, it is plane. F, then G, what is there? G, triangular prism, it is solid figure. H what? Sphere also is solid figure. Okay, then I, octagon, it is plane. I can draw octagon. Octagon, that means what? A figure which of what?
8 faces, octagon. So it is plane figure. Okay. And number J. Number J I am writing here. Number J what? Pyramid. Yes. Pyramid is what? Solid figure. Solid figure. Solid figure. Okay. Okay. Now come to question number. Yes. Now come to question number 10. Okay. Question number 10. What is there? Answer true or false. Each faces of a cubit has 4 edges. It is what? True. Because in a cubit, how many faces are there? How many edges are there? 4 edges. It is what? True. Because if I draw a cubit, then what you see? There are 4 edges I shall get. What? Each face of a cubit has 4 edges. So if I take this face, this one has 1 face. So how many edges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what? Each face has 4 edges. Okay, each face. Suppose if I take this one as 1 face. So this one has how many edges? 1, 2, 3, 4. So each face is like this, what? 4 edges. So it is what? 10. Okay. So question number 10, it is what? So it is true. Okay. So write what? Write true. Answer true or false. So question number 1, it is what? True. Question number 2. A cone has 2 circular faces. A cone has what? 2 circular faces. It is wrong. If I draw a cone, then 1 circular face. Okay. So what? It is false. False. Number 2, 3. What is there? A triangular pyramid has 8 edges. A triangular pyramid has what? 8 edges. It is false. A triangular pyramid has what? A triangular pyramid has how many? 8 edges it is said. But a triangular pyramid has how many edges? 6 edges. But it is given what? 8. Because what? If I draw a triangular pyramid. Here you see. So if I draw a triangular pyramid, then you see how many edges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 edges are there. But it is what? Said it is what? 8 edges. So it is what? False. Okay. Number 4. What? Square is a solid figure with no edges and no vertex. It is true. Because in square, no edges, no vertex, no corner. Okay. A brick has a shape of cube. A brick has a shape of cube. It is false, because brick, do you know, brick means what? With the help of which we construct our what? Houses, buildings. So it is in cube. No, it is what? It is in cube shape. What? Cubed shape. So it is what? False. False. Okay. Now let us move to exercise 12B. So in exercise 12B, what is there? It is said that for each net, name the 3D shapes. For each net, name the what? Name the 3D shapes. So 12B. So what is a net actually? Actually what? A net of a 3-dimensional shape is the outline of its face joined together from which the shape can be formed. Okay. With what I need to show? Okay. Suppose what? Suppose if you take a box, okay. So what? If you take a box going to your home, then what? Suppose if you take a box, okay. And if you, suppose you have taken a box, okay. Suppose a box of a medicine. So if you what? Turn it, then you will see faces like this, okay. Suppose you will see faces like this. There are some faces. Okay. So it will be the faces what after turning the faces whatever you get that will be what suppose this is the what cubed actually I cannot show it this one if I have box then I can show it what a bit nicely okay if I have a nice box a medicine box or anything then I can show it a bit nicely actually but I don't have any medicine box or anything okay suppose what this is what this is a what suppose this is a what cubed okay and these all the faces are closed so whenever I turn this then I will get what some faces like this in this shape what in this shape what I'll get so this what whenever a solid figure is what turned okay then the pages whatever the faces will come these faces are called what nets okay these faces are called what nets so what now come to question number 12 a for each of the net name the 3d shape so what if you what if you you what you just do the practical at your home okay suppose you take a box of you take a box which is in what cubed shape you take a medicine box okay you take a medicine box then after that what you just turn this one so if you turn this one then you will find all the nets are like this okay so if you turn this one okay so you'll find like this okay you do this practical at your home okay suppose you have taken a what cubed okay that is you take a cubical shape any object okay just I'm giving example you take one medicine box which is in what cubed shape and what turn it then you will get the faces like this you just test it you will get the faces like this yes how you see in cubed do you know what how many faces six faces okay so what these are the four sides these are the what four sides that means what suppose this is what cubed shape so I can say the what this is what these are the four sides okay that means what if we fold then these are the what four sides 1 2 3 4 four sides so 1 2 3 4 sides and what to close these two side this one and this one this is what bottom and top that is what one top and one bottom that is what to close this side okay so like this you will get okay you just turn it and you get okay so in question number 1 it is said that what you do this practical by making this one okay so question number 12 what is given that for each net name the 3d shapes so first one will be what cubed that is in this shape okay number 2 if you what cut a piece of paper like this okay and if you join according to the boundaries okay okay if you join this if you fold these things okay whenever you what cut the what this cubed then you will find this net hey again if you join then this will make a what a solid cubed box a solid what cubital box so like this if we join this one like this if we fold this one if we fold this one if we fold then will become what a it will become a what square this is what bottom shape and these are the sides okay so it will become a what square pyramid okay number 3 okay so number 3 what is there number 3 if you do then you will get a what triangular prism
So this shape, if you do like this, okay. So the shapes are given, okay. You just cut some piece of papers and whatever given the shape like this, you fold it, okay. These are the what outlines. These are the what outlines. So at the outlines you just fold, okay. Here you fold it. Here you fold it like this. Here you fold it. So if you fold like this, then that will become a what? Do you know? That will become a triangular pyramid. And number four. Number four, all the faces are same. All the faces are same. Okay. All the faces are same. That is what? All the faces are in the what? Square shape. All the faces are in the square shape. So that is the what? It is a what? Cubed. Because in cubed all the faces are same. So it is what? Cubed. It is what? Cubed. Cube. It is what? Cube. C-U-B-E, cube. Okay. Now come to question number two. So question number two, what is there? You match the net. It is same. Okay. You match the what? Nets. So it is same like question number one. Nets are given. Sorry. Names are given. You have to what? Match the nets. Okay. So number two. See. Number one will match with what? Number four. Number four, it is what? Number four, it is what? Cubed. So number one will match with what? Four. Number two, A. B will be matching with one. Okay. Triangular prism. It is. So it will match with what? Match with one. C, cylinder. Cylinder, if you go, then it is six. Okay. Number D, cube. So cube, all the faces are same. So cube will be matching with five. Five, you see, all the boxes are same. Five figure, you see. So it matches with what? Five. Then E what is there? Square pyramid. So square pyramid, each it matches with three. You see, three figure is what? Is of what? Square pyramid. Okay, you just match. There is nothing to what? Explain. Triangular pyramid. Triangular pyramid matches with what? Two. You see, triangular pyramid, how? Because this is what? Triangular. This shape is in what? Triangular shape. So this will be what? A triangular pyramid. This will be what? A triangular pyramid. So it is what? It is matching with what? Two. Okay. Then G cone. So cone, it is what? Seven. So it is matching with what? Seven. Cone. Okay. So it is what? Seven. Okay. Now come to question number six, high order thinking skill, and it is the last question, and I think all the chapters are finished now. Okay. So this is the end of half yearly course, I think, after solving this question number six. Okay. What shapes would you need to cut out of paper to build a triangular prism? So to build a triangular prism, what do you need? Yes, you see the shapes of the triangular prism, how it is. You see the shapes of what? Triangular prism. You see the shapes of triangular prism, how it is. Let me draw the what? Shapes of triangular prism once again. Okay. So this is the shape of a what? Triangular prism. So in triangular prism, what? We need what? We need what? We need what? Three rectangles. How? Yes, this one rectangle. Okay, this one rectangle. And in the bottom, what? We'll get what? Another rectangle. So what? Three rectangles we need. And what? And two triangles of same size. And two triangles. This are one triangles. And here we'll get what? Here we'll get another triangles. Okay. So this one, what? Two triangles of what? Same size. So what? Number six, what? It is given what? Triangular prism. So right, triangular prism. In case of triangular prism, in triangular prism, what do we need? So what? In triangular prism, what? We need what? Three rectangles. We need what? Three rectangles three rectangles and what? And three rectangles and what? Two triangles of same size and two triangles of same size. Okay, now what? Now for what? Now for cube. So for cube we know what? There are six faces in a cube and all the faces are equal. So what? Square we need. That means what? Six identical square. Identical squares means what? Same. So what? For cube you write. Cube write what? Six. We need six identical squares. Okay, so this is the end of half yearly courses. Okay, and if you find any problem regarding today's class, then you can call me at night. Thank you very much. Practice at your home nicely.